What is up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Jazz. If you are not new here, welcome back. Thank you so much for coming back to see me in another video. So today we are going to be talking about another hair video. I feel like it's been a while since I filmed a hair video. So I just wanted to come back and talk about something that's related to my Microlocs. I just surpassed my 2 month luckiversary. So this video is not going to be like a 2 month update, but I probably will come back to you guys with a 3 month update. Not really too much has changed between my 1 month update and now. So I think 3 month update would make more sense for me to come back to you guys and give you guys a little update. Today, however, we are going to be talking about my experience with retwisting Microlocs, so doing the palm roll method for retightening versus the interlocking method. So I have actually had experience with both of those methods. For my very first retightening that I did, that I also filmed a video on, so if you guys want to go ahead and check that out, head on over to my videos, and while you're there, go ahead and subscribe if you have not already. I'm also going to go ahead and link it up top, whichever side it's going to show up on. But I'm going to link that retwisting video with the palm roll method up top so you can check that out. But recently I have also started interlocking. So, and today I'm going to discuss like the pros and cons of each method from my personal experience. Now this is not going to be a video telling what you should do. I really think it all comes down to personal preference, but I am going to give you guys some tips and pros and cons and things of that nature based on my personal experience. So first, let's go ahead and get started with the palm rolling method. Like I said, that was the first retightening method that I did try with my Microlocs, and I'm going to share a couple pros and cons. So first, let's get started with the pros. So as far as the pros of the palm rolling method, I will say that it was definitely the easier of the two methods to pick up on the technique. Now with palm rolling, I've also had a little bit of experience with palm rolling. My fiance has locs as well. He has traditional locs, and I've been palm rolling his hair for quite a while now, ever since he started locs. So I kind of was familiar with the method, so that wasn't too hard for me to pick up. But I also really think that that's an easier method overall for anybody. I really think anybody can do palm rolling. Just watch a couple videos on YouTube and, you know, you can pretty much learn the technique pretty quickly. So it's definitely the easier of the two to pick up on the technique. Another pro I would say is, and again, this really comes down to personal preference, but I will say that the palm rolling technique does produce a more smooth texture to the lock. So if you're someone who really likes a smoother texture for your lock, I think that this might be a better method for you. So yeah, it definitely creates a different texture versus interlocking. So I would say those are the two main pros. As for the cons, there weren't a whole lot of cons either for palm rolling, but the one main con that I'm about to talk about was a deal breaker for me. So the con with the palm rolling method was that, y'all, it did not last. Like, when I tell y'all it did not last, it did not last. My palm roll lasted about a good 2-3 days before it started to untwist, and it was just a mess. I'm also an active person, so I work out about 5 days a week. I sweat a lot, especially in my scalp. So for me, as soon as I started sweating my scalp, it was just pretty much a wrap for the retwists. It came out beautifully initially. If you go check out the video, I think that it came out really good. But my main problem and why I'm not going to be doing retwisting anymore is it just didn't last. So if you're an active person like myself, then I would probably stray away from the palm roll method, just because it does, of course, it takes a decent amount of time. So if you don't want to feel like you've had your time wasted, then I really wouldn't worry about palm rolling. Now, it could have just been that it was the first time of me palm rolling my own hair. Maybe I didn't do it properly. Maybe I didn't do it well enough for it to last. But for me personally, it just did not hold up through my workouts. So that was really the only con. And although it was the only con, it was just a deal breaker for me. So that's why I'm like done with the palm rolling method. So let's go ahead and move on to interlocking. We'll talk about those pros and cons. As far as the pros of interlocking, the pros of interlocking is it definitely lasts. So that was like the main thing, which is when I was like, okay, started trying interlocking. Yes, this is going to be the method for me, is because it lasted. It lasts through my workouts. It lasts through me sweating. It lasts through my washes. So for me, that's just a deal maker for me. Something that's going to last. I really don't want to have to be worrying about, you know, retightening my hair every couple weeks, or have to worry about the roots being too loose and untwisted. I don't want to have to worry about that too much in between reties. So for me, this is really just the method for me. Now, I am still in the middle of interlocking my hair. I'm not all the way completed with all my locks, y'all. I've been working on it for a while. Now, I would say that is a con of interlocking, is it is more time consuming for me personally. Now, maybe for y'all that have gotten really good at interlocking, and this is my first time, so I'm not very good at it yet, or very fast. So it's taken quite a while. I'm having to break it up over a series of like days in order to get it all done. So that's definitely a con of interlocking, would be that it is more time consuming. It is also a more complicated method, a more complicated technique. So if you are someone who kind of struggles like doing hair, or struggles with your hands or something, the interlocking method may not be the best option for you if you are looking for something that's a little more simple to pick up. Now, YouTube, of course, is super helpful about like interlocking technique and how to do it. But I will say it's something that just comes with practice, of what is what I'm really noticing. It is a little tricky. So for me, I'm doing the two-point rotation. I think that that's the simplest method, just because you're only, you know, you only have 2 points of rotation or whatever. Some people do 3 points, some people do 4 points. Me, I'm not worried about all that yet. I just wanted to kind of master the 2-point rotation. Then if I get better and want to add more rotations, maybe I'll do that. But for right now, I'm just sticking to the 2-point rotation. So yeah, I mean, that's definitely a con of interlocking, is it's more time consuming, and it is also a more complicated technique to pick up on. So yeah, those are the main pros and cons of each method. Like I said at the beginning of the video, it really just comes down to your personal preference. So this is not a video to tell you what you are supposed to do. I don't think that there's any particular method that you're supposed to do. It really just comes down to like what your personal preference is, what your lifestyle is, you know, what you can pick up on the easiest. So that's really all that it comes down to. So at the end of the day, do what's good for you, sis. Choose the method that works best for you. I think what I've noticed, and I'm a newbie in the lock community, so, you know, maybe take what I say with a grain of salt. But I will say that after like researching a lot and looking at a lot of YouTube videos, there do seem to be rules that people will say that you are supposed to follow. And in my experience, I just feel like there's not really any hard and fast rules that you're supposed to like follow. It really all comes down to just works, you know, what works best for you. And that's really just with any type of hair. Like even when, you know, I had loose natural hair, that's really what it came down to too. Even if you don't have locks, it really just comes down to what works best for you and your hair and your lifestyle and your preference. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up right here, y'all. Anybody who is watching this video, if you were all locked, let me know what method that you use and why. And if you have any tips or tricks for people who want to retwist and, you know, want some tips about that, just because I didn't have a good experience, definitely let those people know some good tips and tricks that you use to make sure that your retwists last. Yeah, so go ahead and comment below what method you use. If you guys have any questions, also comment them below in the comments as well. Subscribe, share with a friend, all that good stuff. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.